experience shows him he's most wonderful. My poems and art, I made the mistake of saying from his paintings earlier.
I'm looking forward to hearing you talk about iconography. What drew you to actually, obviously God did, but what drew you to actually, you know, sort of being part of what is a wonderful form of expression? As you say, it's not just paper, it's not painting.
Shed some light to not only my case but to Australia in general. So as you all probably know, I came to Australia around 30 years ago. And I remember the first year was really difficult, maybe year and a half. Quite bleak because I couldn't find any work, not just the work that I wanted, but any work. So I was basically sinking emotionally, which never happened to me before. Simply not the type, but I started worrying very much and thought that maybe I made the wrong decision by coming here. And then things changed, something happened. Suddenly I woke up from that kind of nightmare, so to say. I got a job teaching icon painting in colleges. I was very happy. Started working as an interpreter, translator, so it was paying the bills and I was absolutely all right. At that time I lived in Bondi. I remember I got a phone call from a lady. She says, Michael, I heard about you. I'm from the neighborhood. I heard about your work and you know, I just got a grant to make a documentary about immigrants, migrants who have just settled here in Australia, who are artists and had a rough time, had it rough at the beginning and very rough to the point of, you know, almost cultivating suicide. So tell me about your case. So over the phone I said, yes, you're right, the first year was really tough and maybe I said a few things about that and then started waxing lyrical, started being happy, saying, but it all kind of passed, thank God, I'm very fine now. I started talking about how great I feel now, that all that is over behind me, that I'm getting commissions, that I regularly have a regular income and stuff like that. She said, okay, I'll call you, she said, with some sort of hesitance in her voice. So she never called again, and I called her and said, what happened? She said, oh, what happened? Well, you don't qualify. You are too happy. Then, a few years into that, I got the job to paint the whole church in Guildford, Maryland. An iconostasis in the whole church, all icons for the Greek Melkite Catholic Church, so-called. I was absolutely over the moon about that job because it's once in a lifetime that you get to do the whole church, really. So the day of the opening of the church came. So it was a Sunday, I remember well. A warm Sunday, I came, of course, from my little Bondi, in t-shirt and kind of maybe jeans or something. That was 25 years ago. I decided it would be much better than I do now. So the church was so packed that I couldn't enter the church. So I was with those who could make it to the church, into the church, but we could kind of see through the movement of people, glimpses of gold, the iconostasis was there, you know, the censer was there, the chanting was magical, everything was absolutely phenomenal. And one man who was standing there said, don't you see how magnificent this is? Isn't it great? And
I
saying yes is, and I'm glad that I have done those things, those idols. And he looked at me up and down and just smiled, laughed me off. What happened was, at the moment he did that, I actually realized what happened. He thought, I'm far too young, don't look too serious to be a master of such a beauty that happens in his own church. I had to be a guy with a long white beard. So we fast-tracked the whole thing to 10 years ago. When I was 60, I came to see the one of the top five dealers, car dealers in Sydney. Somehow I deluded myself that he would give me a show. He saw the book said, I don't know, the book is fantastic, he said, but this, I decidedly didn't want to go with icons for a show because I don't display them in commercial galleries, but just my contemporary artwork, be it religious or not religious. He said, but these works, they don't even look contemporary. And also, he said, I'm sorry, but you are old. What? From that moment until now, past decade was by far the most fruitful and productive that I ever had. And from the creative point of view, from the productivity point of view, from the fulfilling point of view, it enriched me and made me feel enormously well about possibilities to expand, to better myself, venture into the uncharted territories for myself, because at all times I try to challenge myself and do something that I haven't done before. I'm not trying to play safe all the time. I have really several projects on the boil, so to say, and I would like to kind of tackle them with utmost care. One of them is, let's say, the series of icons of St. George slaying a dragon. The other one is Archangel Michael. Plus, I'm finishing the book to be published hopefully next year about Christ through his life, crucifixion and resurrection through my traditional icons and contemporary works. So there is a lot of things going on.